Hi everyone! In this video you will learn all about theorems for right-angled triangles, and in this video you will learn the Bach theorem. So, in this chapter we've looked a lot at the Pythagorean theorem, which could be used in right-angled triangles only. Today is the Bach theorem. So, what you must know, when we have a triangle, a right angle triangle, in this case ABC. Opposite to our B vertex is our side, which we call B. Opposite to our A vertex is our AH. And opposite to our C is our CH. And then we can also draw the a perpendicular height, or the altitude, which is called h. So, when we're going to calculate the area, so area of triangle ABC, we could do a half times b times a, because we're going to do it like the length times the perpendicular height. But we can also calculate it in a different way. So we can also say the area triangle ABC equals a half times C times H, because this is a side, the length times its perpendicular height, H. Alright, so actually those two things are the same. So we can write down a half times B times A is the same, so equals a half times C times H. Because on both sides there's a half, so we can just cancel them out. So we get B times A equals C times H. And if we stick it together, we get BA equals CH or Bach. So this is how our Bach theorem existed, and the proof that this is indeed equal to it. If you do not totally get this, do not worry, but please remember our Bach theorem. So let's have a look at an example. So I'm already going to give you kind of a spoiler alert that BC equals the square root of 64 equals 8 centimeters. But how did we do this? Because we want to calculate CD. CD is over here, and it's part of a right angle triangle. That's what we can see, of a right angle triangle DBC. So we can check if we can use a Pythagorean theorem. But in this case, we cannot, because we do not know DB. We do not know BC, and we do not know CD. So we can't use it. So maybe we can use it for this right angle triangle. Again, we do not know what CD is. We do know what AC is, but we have absolutely no idea what AD is. The only thing we know is that AB is 10. So therefore, we miss some information, and we cannot use a Pythagorean theorem for this. And that's when we can use our Bach theorem. So what we have, and please remember, opposite to our C, so opposite to C, it's called our CH. Opposite to our A, it's called our AH. And opposite to B, it's our BH. And our Bach theorem was BA equals CH. So let's fill this in with letters according to our triangle. So AC times BC equals AD times CD. Then you're going to fill everything in that you know. So 6 times BC equals 10 times CD. And again, we miss some information. And that's when our Pythagorean theorem helps us. Because we can calculate what BC is. Because we know that this is ABC is a right angle triangle where we can use a Pythagorean theorem. So AC squared plus BC squared is the same as AB squared. So we use a Pythagorean theorem. And we're going to fill everything in. So 6 squared plus B squared equals 10 squared is 36 plus BC squared equals 100. I'm going to subtract 36 on both sides using the balance method. And then I get BC squared equals 64. So, my little spoiler alert, BC is the square root of 64 equals 8 centimeters. And now we can fill our Bach method in further. So we get 6 times 8, because of the 8 centimeters, equals 10 times CD. Please simplify this to 48 equals 10 CD. Divide both sides by 10, because we want to know what 1 CD is, and then we can see that CD is 4.8 centimeters. So that's how we can use the Bach theorem mixed with our Pythagorean theorem. Please make sure that you practice this a lot and that you remember what the rule is. If you have any questions, then please ask them now. And otherwise, good luck with practicing.